Hello and welcome to this video on relational calculus in DBMS and its types, which are tuple relational calculus and domain relational calculus. This is Inder P. Singh. First, in this relational calculus tutorial, let me explain relational calculus database. It is a formal language, meaning it uses special symbols. In DBMS Introduction to Relational Calculus, you should know that it's a non-procedural query language, meaning that you don't need to give the procedure or steps, but simply query the data in a declarative way. Relational calculus has two main types. Tuple relational calculus uses quantifiers to specify the constraints, and domain relational calculus, which uses domains, which are collections of values. In Tupl relational calculus DBMS, there are two quantifiers. The first quantifier is called universal quantifier, and this is a symbol of the universal quantifier. It is read as for all meaning it is applicable to each tuple in the relation. This is an example of the universal quantifier for all x such that x is a customer and x has placed an order. So here this means that each customer must have placed an order, because the condition is that x is a customer and x has placed an order. The second quantifier is the existential quantifier, and this is a symbol of the existential quantifier. This means any. Any means one or more. The example of existential quantifier is, there exists x such that x is a customer and x has placed an order and the order date is greater than 1st January 2023. So here, using the existential quantifier, which is read as there exists, it means that there must be at least one customer, because the meaning of the existential quantifier is any, that means one or more. So there must be at least one customer who has placed an order after 1st January 2023. Tuple relational calculus query. Query means a question that we ask the DBMS. So tuple relational calculus query specifies the desired tuples in the DBMS based on conditions defined using quantifiers that we just saw, the universal quantifier and the existential quantifier, and the relationships between sets of data. For example, x such that x is a tuple in the order relation. The order relation basically means that there is a table called order and x is a tuple, meaning one row in the order table. And x dot customer id, so in that row the customer id field value is equal to y dot customer id, and y is a tuple in the customer relation, that means y is a row in the customer table, and the value in the country field of that row is USA. So here, using relational calculus, we have just given the queries, meaning that we have specified what we want in a non-declarative way, meaning we have not given the steps but just declared what we want. So this query retrieves all tuples from the order relation, because it is going to retrieve x, where the customer's country is USA. And where it gets this information from? It is going to get this information from the customer table. In relational calculus, there is something called safe relational calculus expression. In short, SRE, safe relational calculus expression. Now in DBMS tuple relational calculus, SRE is defined as a set of conditions that are safe and finite. Safe conditions mean that they don't modify the database, and finite means that These conditions only retrieve information from the database. Now the SRE definition is written in this format and we'll see an example of it next. This is a universal quantifier for all x1, x2 until xn for any number of tuples and given the conditions c1, c2, c3 until cm. This is the safe relational calculus expression. This is how it is written. Now with the safe relational calculus expression definition in mind, let us see the example. So here the example is using the universal quantifier for all x, and the conditions are given as employee x and department ID of x is equal to D1 and salary of x is greater than 50,000, and this means implies. So after all these conditions, what we want is the employee name. This example means that x is the variable that ranges over all tuples in the employee table. So it is going to look in the employee table and take each row one by one. For each row, it is going to verify that all the conditions are being satisfied. The condition employee x states that x is a tuple or row in the employee table. And the conditions department ID x is equal to D1. So it is going to take one row in the employee table and find out what is the value given in the department ID field. And that value has to be equal to D1. Then in that row, it is going to look in the salary field and find out if the value given is greater than 50,000. So these specify the additional conditions for the query. Then this is the final expression. Employee name returns the value of the employee name attribute, meaning the value given in the employee name field for that row that satisfies all the conditions. So this is how we write a safe relational calculus expression. The second main type of relational calculus in DBMS is domain relational calculus. It has a couple of building blocks. The first building block is the domain. A domain means a set of values. So for example, a domain of age would specify that the data must be an integer value representing a person's age. So this is the age domain. The second building block in domain relational calculus is the relation. Now, a relation in domain relational calculus is a collection of ordered pairs of values. So, for example, a relation may contain an ordered pair John, 28. So, here this means is that this is a person whose name is John and whose age is 28 years old. And this is in the age domain. Now let us see some examples in domain relational calculus, how we write the expressions in domain relational calculus. So first example is, let us say the constraint is for all people their age must be greater than 0. So this particular constraint or condition can be expressed in domain relational calculus as using the quantifier for all, because this condition has to be satisfied for all people. For all x, person x, so x is going to be a tuple in the person table, implies that age attribute of x, that means the value in the age field, has to be greater than 0. So this is how the domain building block is used in the expression for the constraint. So the expression person x means that x is a member of the domain person, and the expression age x greater than 0 means the value of age for x is greater than 0. And because we are using the universal quantifier, this constraint has to be applicable for all the tuples. Another expression in domain relational calculus is using the existential quantifier, which means there exists x, person x, and so this is the logical AND operator. There is also logical OR operator and NOT operator, but here we are using the logical AND operator, and age X is equal to 28. So here it means that there has to be any, that means at least one tuple that satisfies these conditions, that it has to be in the person relation and the age attribute has to have the value of 28. So the expression person X and age X is equal to 28 means there exists a member of the domain person with an age of 28. At least one. There could be more than one, but at least one person is going to have the value of 28 in the age field. That's all in this relational calculus in DBMS tutorial. In the next tutorial, I will explain enhanced entity relationship model and other DBMS topics. Please view this complete database management system full course in the database management system in English playlist. Thank you.